Ball number 9 is back, or should I say New Harlem is. Roll intro, roll video. Valentine's Day 2022 will be extra special for select fragrance lovers, given the fact that Bond No. 9 officially announced the return of New Harlem on the day of. Now, if you're unfamiliar with New Harlem or Bond No. 9 as a whole, maybe because you're newer to the fragrance game, just know that Bond No. 9 is or was New York's most prolific fragrance brand. People really dug the bottle design, as well as the synthetic yet bold signature scent quality of a lot of their scents, and they also maybe took solace in their high price points as well. But that was then and this is now. Amidst a couple of controversies, ever-rising prices, and as a result the gray market because not as many fragrances were selling, and the online fragrance community now discovering other upcoming niche brands, I think it's safe to say that Bond No. 9's mainstream prominence has kind of waned outside of a few celebs rocking their stuff. On top of that, what Bond was initially hallowed for was and is something that purists also like to denigrate him for to the day, and that is quite a few of their fragrances are eerily similar to other established industry favorites. And if anything, New Harlem was arguably the most hallowed of those high-end dupes, if you want to call them that. The infectious take on vanilla, tonka, and mainly coffee was just undeniable, and definitely more upscale than Michael Jordan Legend and Rojas Man before it, the latter of which perfumer Maurice Roussel also created prior to New Harlem. So you might be wondering, why was this fragrance off Bond's website and the market altogether for a couple years in the first place? Did it not sell well? Who knows? And sure, a rep might have told you that it wasn't actually discontinued, but usually if something is just unavailable due to sourcing ingredients, or if they are changing the pricing or packaging, or if it is officially sold out, then the link will still be active on any brand's website usually. So part of me wants to believe that New Harlem was truly discontinued due to how its link has been relisted circa November 2021. Because we'll be back Valentine's Day 2022 sounds awfully a lot like bring something back from the grave, just saying. So instead of speculating on why it was off the market for a couple years, let's just take a closer look at why they chose to make such a grandiose announcement for its revival. For one, once the stock dried up at various official points of sale, as well as the gray market, it was the secondhand market that noticeably inflated. Like for maybe two-thirds full of a 100ml and no box, you have people lining up on eBay for $450 US. $450. All of this while being way above what New Harlem initially retailed for. So if Bond likely sees all the uproar since for something that people can no longer have, they must also see this as quite the opportunity as well. Like if people are crazy enough to buy it at 400 plus, how about at retail with more peace of mind at 325? But will it even sell like that just because? Because on the other hand, people may even convince themselves of higher quality for the scent or a stronger emotional connection in some ways. But in reality, they just lust for collecting something that is no longer readily accessible anymore. So even if it comes back at 325 and is technically a deal all things considered in the last few years, I can't say I'd be shocked if it bombed sadly. Again, because I think people may be insane enough to take more solace in a $400 plus discontinued scent because it is discontinued, rather than the same stuff at retail for 325 because of its scent. Now before we get into the next part, I hope you guys also dig different fragrances of different price points because you already know I do. So because of that love, because of the work that we put in here at Cascade Scents, I also do get asked what's another way I can help support this channel. Maybe I'll have donations or Patreon set up in the near future, maybe merch of some sort, I don't know, but that stuff is at the end of the day gonna cost some money, so why not offer you something that you can help me support me with for free. So I'm simply asking you guys to subscribe to this channel if you have yet to. That and also hit the notification bell if you want to be among the first people to view this kind of content. I'd love to have you climb aboard the 30,000 subscriber train because that is our next goal. And yeah, you know I can't do this without you. So really appreciate y'all and continue to enjoy the show. On to the next one now. So who knows how New Harlem's next run will actually fare, but for the sake of the scent and some of you hardcores who truly love it, I hope you go out there and buy it at retail, enjoy it, and that it sells well. Because if you don't enjoy it at retail and or enough liquidations ensue, and thus wind up on the gray market, that's how things actually get discontinued. Just look at how some dogs miss the mark as far as the masses go, despite some community enthusiasm. I swear, you probably had more Van Cleef reps throwing in Midnight in Paris for free with a 10K necklace than people actually looking to buy it, which is why these things were ending up on FragranceNet for 20 bucks a pop 6 years ago, sadly. It goes without saying that stuff is long discontinued now, so again, if you really, really, really like something, buy it at retail unless you want to contribute to why it goes away. And for the record, if I'm not being clear enough, I'm talking about less popular stuff, of course. Because I'm sure a Creed rep won't be sweating too hard over gray market Aventus given how many 401k types keep re-upping at retail, just saying. So yeah, I think this is where I almost want to end the video. Hope you feel up to speed on how the gray market works once again, and or the new Harlem situation here most importantly. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button, subscribe, as well as hit the notification bell as well in case you want to be here ASAP for more upcoming videos, you know, because it's the right thing to do. And also tell me in the comments below if you are also excited for New Harlem 2022 and if you do think it is worth it at $325. And on that note, I might as well give you my answer to that question, and that is a big nope, even despite being a steal at $325 in comparison to that secondhand market. Guys, I just think it smells uber cheap in comparison to other gourmands in that price range. So inexpensive, in fact, that I personally wouldn't even buy it at half of the retail price. Like, that's how not high I am on New Harlem and or other bonds in general. Just doesn't smell like luxury to me and or feel as pleasant as other mainstream niche brands. So yeah, no longer for me, but again, I can't express how happy I am for everyone else who genuinely wants to pick this up. But on the other hand, if I really wanted to go after that synthetic breakfasty DNA, either the prior Michael Jordan Legend or Rojas Man, I think, are each stellar for their respective gray market rates. Anyway, thank you for the ongoing support. I'll catch you next time. Take care for now. Peace out. Bye. My name is Manny. Wear your fragrances.